There's tremendous technology innovation taking place. We have robots that are starting to power manufacturing sites around the world. There are artificial intelligence solutions that are making a big difference in healthcare, in education, and criminal justice. We see restaurants are starting to use mobile tablets, so people come in and instead of placing their order with a human waitress or waiter, they are ordering right off of that tablet. Retail workers and sales clerks constitute about 6% of the American workforce. That's about 8 million workers altogether. They are very subject to automation. Stores are looking for ways to cut costs. And there are mobile applications that can basically replace these retail clerks. When you think about all these technologies, we really are facing a very different type of situation. It's going to be very challenging. There are certain individuals who are going to be quite vulnerable to these changes. Many of the entry-level positions in finance and in the restaurant business are at great risk of having their jobs subject to automation. There are racial minorities which already face big problems of prejudice and discrimination in the workforce. They may face an even more challenging future as well. One sign of how things have changed is if you look at the largest American companies in the 1960s versus the largest ones today. AT&T was the big company in the 1960s and it had something like 564,000 employees. Today, Facebook is much larger and a much more valuable company. It barely has 20,000 employees. So what the large tech companies have discovered is you don't have to be that big to have very large platforms and a very high stock valuation. So the disruption is real. There's certainly going to be new jobs that are created, but many of those new jobs are going to require advanced technical skills that many Americans do not have.